Listen to the student reporter press Irama.
Do you not think that it's damaging for sexual assault victims to see the person who sexually assaulted or raped them on grounds?
I think it absolutely can be.
So why are they allowed back on grounds?
Because I think we are trying to balance the rights of the individual who's being accused as well as the rights of the complainant, and sometimes that's very difficult.
Scores of current and former students have written letters supporting Dean Irama, and despite the way her case was handled, Jackie, the woman at the center of the storm, has stepped back into the spotlight again to show her support as well, writing, "Dean Irama has truly saved my life. If it were not for her, I do not know if I could be alive today." We reached out to Dean Irama on Tuesday. She works in this building behind me on the UVA campus. We were told by an aide she would not make herself available for comment. The aide would not take our telephone number and said the dean would not call us later for a conversation on the phone. Joe John, CNN, Charlottesville, Virginia.
Meanwhile, in Hong Kong, seven police officers have been arrested over an alleged assault on a pro-democracy protester last month. This video of the alleged beating sparked outrage across the city. It shows what appears to be officers punching and kicking a man after leading him to a dark corner. The alleged victim was later identified as a member of a local political party. After the break, we hit the road with a pack of bikers in Los Angeles. It'll be quite the ride. Not even traffic police were able to keep up. Stay with us.
Open Court, in association with RADA.
It's been a year of firsts for this Japanese superstar.
I had a great year so far. I had a final in US Open and I won four titles this year.
The 24-year-old is the first Asian-born man to advance to a Grand Slam singles final and qualify for the season-ending championship. Experts have always been impressed by his quickness, but wondered if he was strong enough to reach the top.
I thought, you know, top 30. Then the next time they asked me, I said top 20. And then I said top 10, and now look at him. So, I mean, it's just, you can just see he is really an achiever. He's somebody who pushes himself. He maximizes his abilities.
During the past year, tennis legend Michael Chang joined the Young Stars coaching team. Kay knows there's little time to rest if he wants to make history and become a Grand Slam champion.
What does it mean to go there? It doesn't mean reading about it. It means packing a bag and going there and talking to the people. Talking to activists in secret. Activists risking their lives for speaking to a Western journalist in Damascus. Talking to people on the margins of the story about how they're affected by the decisions of those much more powerful than them. That is why I go there, to get the story firsthand.
Every country has an identity, a history, customs, culture. A unique landscape that determines how its people live, work, and play. Now, get an insider's look with CNN's On the Road.
From the exquisite restoration of Machia homes to Taiko Revival and the stunning landscapes of Naoshima, the art island, join me as we explore Japan.
CNN On the Road, Japan. All next week on CNN.
Take a look at this. A motorcyclist in Los Angeles went on a wild ride. We can certainly see that. Police chasing them the whole way, in fact. CNN's Jeannie Mose shows us bikers behaving so dangerously, it might give you road rage.
Crazy. Reckless. Asinine. Pack of motorcyclists taunting a police car giving chase. Doing stunts, and not just doing wheelies, but doing wheelies right next to the police car. This brazen six-minute video was posted on YouTube. It shows bikers in Los Angeles driving on the wrong side of the road, running red lights, When a police car tries to cut them off, well, it's hard to tell who's chasing whom. More often than not, it's the police car that seems surrounded. There's even a police chopper with a spotlight giving chase from above. Which is apparently why the bikers take cover under an overpass, a few dozen of them, then make a mass exodus. Though the chopper and its spotlight are still there, in the only accident seen on the video, one of the motorcyclists wipes out. We have no idea if he was seriously hurt. At one point, one biker says to another, jackets handed over, we're guessing, to somehow make identification harder. Eventually, they turn down a pedestrian walkway. They come out driving without lights, turn down an alley, park in the dark. The guy who posted the video says a few of the riders were caught and arrested, but most escaped. We tried to confirm that with Los Angeles police. But LAPD told us they were too tied up with the Ferguson protest to deal with questions about this. Motorcyclists gone wild. Police seem powerless to do anything but let these bikers slide. Ginny Mo, CNN, New York.
The video currently with 827,000 views. So people are watching it. You're watching CNN at the moment, though. I'm Max Foster in London. Early Start is next for those of you in the US, and for our international viewers, I'll be right back with a check of the headlines for you.
Story, you may be asked to take risks and sometimes go down a path that's not marked. That's where you find a brotherhood risking it all, or a fighter who's had a change of heart. When you dare to take risks, you witness passion and persistence, and that's where change happens.
Hi, this is Celine Dion asking you to help put an end to premature birth. I share the concerns and fears of every parent, knowing that more than 1 million babies around the world die every year simply because they didn't get enough time to grow. Let's work together for stronger, healthier babies. Visit facebook.com/worldprematurityday to find out how you can make a difference. Thank you for caring.
Is to get the viewers to understand the world around them. People are starved for news about the world and context about the world. The show is able to appeal to people at every level.
Fareed Zakaria GPS, Sunday on CNN.
Season's greetings from CNC3. This time check is brought to you by Sunshine Granola Crunch Sachets. Sunshine Cereals, wake up to a better breakfast every day.
Good morning, Trinidad and Tobago. I'm Hema Ramkisoon, and this is the Morning Brew. How are you today? It is a beautiful Thursday morning. And this morning, as is customary, we're going to continue to follow all of the major stories affecting life in Trinidad and Tobago. But before we get into our first interview this morning, and before we check in with the news team, let's remind you why you should buy the Trinidad and Tobago Guardian this morning. The front page of the Guardian newspaper, $346 million loss, and TNTech's power supply. We're going to find out a little bit about that this morning on the show. And there we continue to monitor what's taking place in Tobago. A picture there of the relatives of the Celine couple. And that is one story we continue to follow. We're going to check in with the news team at this time. I'm Hema Ramki. Soon, this is The Morning Brew. I'll see you after the news.
Good morning, I am Akash Samaru with your news headlines on CNC3 and the TBC Radio Network. Opposition Chief Whip and PNM Deputy Political Leader Malin McDonald says if Patrick Manning decides to offer himself for screening as a candidate for San Fernando East, he will be given due consideration. Speaking with reporters yesterday, she says the party intends to offer the best possible slate of candidates for the 2015 general elections.
When they selected Mr. Manning, and Mr. Manning went through the screening process, I believe that they are satisfied, the constituents would be satisfied with who was selected, and they voted resoundingly for Mr. Manning. And from where I sit, I think that Mr. Manning represented his constituents very well, very well. Who will determine whether he is so, if he continues, would be his constituents and the screening committee.
In other news, Acting Police Commissioner Stephen Williams is denying that his officers are mistreating the man held in connection with the Brasso Seco kidnappings and murders. When questioned about the allegations being made by prisoner Asman Alexander, Commissioner Williams says officers are acting professionally and handling the prisoner in accordance with the law.
Police are dealing with him in the way the law provides for us to deal with any prisoner. I don't know about the request, but there is no special provision in the law for a person to request all that he wants in life when he's in custody.
Meanwhile, the Acting Commissioner of Police will commend all the officers involved in the investigation in the missing Brasso Seco family and who also held prisoner Asman Alexander. The police service says the commendation ceremony will take place today at the Police Training Academy. Over 20 officers are expected to be recognized for their work. And Tourism Minister Gerald Hadid says this country remains a safe destination for tourism. The minister says what has happened in Tobago with the murder of a German couple is regrettable. He insists that the government and THU working together will ensure that the crime is solved.
Trinidad and Tobago is a safe destination for tourism, especially Tobago. Issues that has happened is regrettable. It seems to take place anytime Tobago is on the verge of a major push in tourism. It is so sad. Our government, working hand in hand with the Tobago House of Assembly, promised the world that we will solve this crime. We will ensure that the perpetrator or perpetrators of this act will be brought to justice.
And that was your 6 a.m. news here on CNC3 and the TBC Radio Network. The Morning Brew with Hema Ramki soon is up next.
When The Guardian rolls off the press, something more than news travels throughout the country. Like awareness from in-depth investigations that explore every role. And insightful reporting that you can be passionate about. There's satisfaction for those who need a higher level of analysis and confidence in well-researched information that gives you the edge. Even quality time from a family of entertaining features, online or offline.
So whoever, wherever you are, trust The Guardian to deliver what matters.
I've been shopping at Mirage Westside Supermarket for over 50 years, and I get my groceries home and drop free.
They have the best prices and the best quality that I could think of.
They have heavy security.
Over three different places to park.
You're shopping comfort.
I'm not going anywhere else to shop, but
actually, I am one of their very first customers way back in the 60s.
Mirage Westside Supermarket, serving you for the past 50 years.
Do not risk your life using ladders and homemade scaffolds. Rent your scaffolds and be safe. Visit DMA Transport and Scaffolding Services Limited. We specialize in tube and clamp, H-frame, cut block, and acro props. We have an excellent reputation for our high-quality product, competitive prices, fast delivery times, reliable service, constant adherence to on-site safety, certified scaffolders. We also specialize in general construction and maintenance services. So visit or call DMA Transport and Scaffolding Services Limited. Telephone 674-6178.
It's a two-day mega scratch and dent sale this Friday and Saturday at BrandSource. Everything at factory prices. Everything must go. BrandSource mega scratch and dent sale this Friday and Saturday. BrandSource number 121 Monroe Road, Kunopia. 693-2421.
While others are getting more expensive, DirecTV is offering you a deal that will save you money for an entire year.
I'm signing up.
Now, for just $289 per month, you can enjoy HBO and HD, or HBO and DirecTV Plus, where you can pause, record, and rewind live TV.
Wait, stop!
It's a monster deal that locks in your price and protects your savings for a full year.
What is it that I have to do to make this happen?
Just call DirecTV and sign up today. DirecTV, life-changing.
Par Excellence is the number one housewife's choice in Trinidad and Tobago and is now introducing a new range of products. White rice, parboiled rice, white sugar, brown sugar, and much more. Available at leading supermarkets nationwide.
Begin your university degree in January 2015. The University of the Southern Caribbean does not just offer degrees in education, business, humanities, social sciences, science and technology, and theology. We prepare you for life. CAPE, CSEC, and adult entry options are available. Sign up today at any of our campuses in Maracas, St. Joseph, San Fernando, or Tobago, and let USC take you beyond excellent.
Join the Guardian Neediest Cases Fund for a family movie night at the premiere of Annie, Movie Town, Port of Spain on Tuesday, December 16th. Take a donation, $125. The movie starts at 7 p.m. Exciting door prizes to be won. Get your tickets at all Guardian offices, St. Vincent Street, Port of Spain, Mid-Center Mall, Chagones, High Street, San Fernando, or online at www.guardian.co.tt. So come on out, bring the family, and let's enjoy a great movie for a great cause.
The Morning Brew is brought to you in part by Wendy's.
Good morning, Trinidad and Tobago. I'm Imran Kisun, and this is The Morning Brew. Welcome. It's a beautiful Thursday morning. This morning, as is customary, we're going to continue to follow all of the major stories affecting life in Trinidad and Tobago. Our first interview will be via telephone with Kelvin Ramsuk, the general manager of TN Tech, and this is coming out of a story. Are we expected to see a dark Christmas? So we're going to follow that story and so much more. Also, our first interview on set will be with one of the newest faces in the People's National Movement, and that is young attorney-at-law Stuart Young. He has decided to throw his hat in the ring and basically enter the political arena. So we're going to find out what's happening and why has he decided to take up the offer by the PNM and give up his law practice. Also, we will be speaking with Fudi Ferreira following the Manning story as we look at how the situation in the San Fernando constituency continues to unfold. But before we begin our first interview, which will be via telephone this morning, let's give you something to think about while you share a morning cup of coffee with us, Trinidad and Tobago. The love of family and the admiration of friends is much more important than wealth and privilege. I'm going to read that again for you. The love of family and the admiration of friends is much more important than wealth and privilege. that's something for you to think about. At this point, we are going to link up with Kelvin Ramsook. Now, as you know, the big story on the newspaper this morning, TN Tech news that there may be a possible load shedding, or is it as a result of a gas leak in the point in one of the gas plants? Well, to clarify what's happening, we have Mr. Ramsook on the telephone. Mr. Ramsook, good morning. Thank you for joining us.
Morning, morning, Hema, and morning to all the customers of Trinidad and Tobago, all the residents.
Now, obviously, Mr. Ramsook, one of the newspapers highlighted a dark Christmas. What is happening, and should we be concerned? And that, I think, is a general question, and the one question that consumers would like answered this morning.
All right, so Hema, just to put it in perspective, yesterday afternoon, a leak developed on the line that supplies the Trinidad Generation Unlimited. So we were notified at TN Tech that the based on that leak, that the TGU plant will have to be taken out of service, of course, because of the loss of in-feed gas to the plant. We immediately put all our mechanisms in place. We did, of course, notify the nation to conserve. And overnight, just to give you an idea of what's happening, overnight, between yesterday afternoon and overnight, we notified all our industrial customers in the Point Lisas Industrial Estate, as well as other plants like TCL, Petrotrin, and so on, Caribbean bottlers, that their supply will be curtailed as we move in this morning in terms of our normal load. Now, just to mention, our total demand expected during the day today, so we didn't have to shed anybody overnight. We didn't have to shed any customers overnight.
Now, are we expected to see load shedding at all during this period while the NGC line is going through maintenance and upgrades?
No, it's very unlikely. At this point in time, our total expected demand for this morning is 1250 megawatts. That's our general demand. Our available capacity from the other provider, that is PowerGen, Trinity, and of course we have the coal plant. Our total expected capacity is roughly, as I said, 1250 is the demand, and 1050 is the available capacity. So we have a shortfall of about 200 megawatts. And that, by curtailing the industrial customers, as I said, PCS, Yara, CNC, Titan, Centrin, and so on, all the methanol plants at the Point Lisas Industrial Estate, we would be in a good position to be able to maintain supply to the rest of the country as we allow NGC to effect repairs on that leak.
How long is it expected to go on like this, Mr. Ramsook?
Right. Okay. So what is happening is that NGC is signaling that generally, you know, a repair of that nature will normally take 4 days.
Mm-hmm.
So today is Thursday. So if we look at 4 days, really our biggest challenge will be today and tomorrow, because as you go into the weekend, Saturday and Sunday, we would be in a good position in terms of our available capacity, not to have to curtail even the industrial customers. So just today and tomorrow would really be our difficult days in terms of having to hold back the industrial customers in terms of operating between today and tomorrow.
And the industrial customers, are they satisfied, or are they willing to participate and support this initiative?
Are giving us support, but, you know, Hema, like anything else, if we, you know, we did signal because of this scenario that we are in, we will have to switch them off if, they are supporting us, but certainly we would have no choice if given our predicament right now. But just one thing I want to get in to mention, Hema. While we had asked our customers, and we really pleaded again, because overnight we did look at the demand on the system, and what we observed is that there were very little curtailment mm-hmm. by any of the customers as such when we looked at our general demand overnight.
Mm-hmm.
So we again pleaded to the residents. I mean, we know we're not going to affect, as I say, the country is going to have its normal supply except for the industrial customers. But if you have items that are not critical that you could avoid using, really between today and tomorrow, and especially between the period of 5:30 and 9:30 in overnight, and that is really when we hit our major peak, we would really appreciate, you know, if they could curtail the use of major appliances and so on, so that we could maintain continuity of supply.
And it's just a four-day period you're expecting?
Right.
Okay. Mr. Ramsu, thanks so much for joining us this morning to clarify what's taking place. One of the newspapers saying it's a dark Christmas, TN Tech saying it's not so. They have put a contingency plan in place, four-day maintenance period or a repair period for the NGC line. And he's expecting the next 2 days to really be the critical period. And they have advised their industrial customers that some changes will be expected to take place over the next 48 hours. We take a very short short break. When we come back, our first interview begins with Stuart Young, young attorney at law. He's now one of the newest faces on the PNN's platform. We're going to find out why. Stay with us.
Need to fix your plumbing, shower, or bathroom? Yes, we have that too. Pipes, shower fittings, toilets, the widest range of Makita, Stanley, and all other hardware supplies at competitive prices. Visit our website or come in today at 185 Union Road, Marabella. Southern Wholesale Stores Limited. More than just a hardware.
Sometimes the protection that is available is not what you need. Support can be forthcoming in abundance, but it just does not fit. Your specific needs seem not to be important. And as a result, neither is your shot at success. Don't settle for just any support and protection. What you need is FlexiCover from Furness Anchorage General Insurance. We will design a coverage package that will suit your workmen's compensation, public liability, contractors all risk, and performance bonds needs. Contact your broker or Furness Anchorage General Insurance today and get FlexiCover. Furness Anchorage, a symbol of quality and trust.
Green Dot Limited, wireless, digital, cable and internet masters. No phone lines necessary. Quick and easy installation. Unlimited internet access. Call 623-4643 and be part of the Green Dot today.
It's a mega one-day sale this Sunday at Buyer's Mart. Plastic chairs, 75. 18-inch Lasco fan, 275. Half HP water pump, 350. Foot spa, 199. Beach chair, 99. 4-foot pre-lit Christmas tree, 150. Oven with rotisserie, 695. 8-piece car cover seat, 199. 4-slice toaster, 99. 4x6 mattress, 325. Thousands of items on sale. Don't miss this one. One day only.
At this time of year, you try to do whatever it takes to make everything just right. And Digicel is here to help you with our unlimited Go Social plans. Get unlimited access to your favorite apps like Facebook, WhatsApp, Instagram, and Twitter for as little as $5.99 per day. Simply dial *323# to activate your Go Social plan. Digicel.
Car Excellence is the number one housewife's choice in Trinidad and Tobago and is now introducing a new range of products. White rice, parboiled rice, white sugar, brown sugar and much more. Available at leading supermarkets nationwide.
Join the Guardian Neediest Cases Fund for a family movie night at the premiere of Annie. Movie Town, Port of Spain on Tuesday, December 16th. Take your donation, $125. The movie starts at 7 p.m. Exciting, door prizes to be won. Get your tickets at all Guardian offices. St. Vincent Street, Port of Spain, Mid-Center Mall, Chaguanas, High Street, San Fernando, or online at www.guardian.co.tt. So come on out, bring the family, and let's enjoy a great movie for a great cause.
RNS Music St. James Street, San Fernando announces a big Christmas deal. Get 20% on drums, 20% on guitars, and 25% on keyboards. All music equipment, instruments, and accessories in stock at the best prices at RNS Music San Fernando.
Welcome back, Trinidad and Tobago. I'm here with Ram Kisoon, and this is The Morning Brew. Well, joining us on set now, one of the newest faces of the People's National Movement, one of the candidates unveiled. And as you know, the PNM, well, they're telling Trinidad and Tobago, this is our team. This is our team for 2015. Joining us on set now, Stuart Young, well-known attorney at law, and he's going up for Port of Spain North, St. Anne's West. He has decided, you know what, I'm going to do this for country. Good morning. How are you?
Good morning, Hema. Not too bad. Thank you very much for having me on your program.
Now, obviously, Mr. Young, the first question I have to ask you, why are you deciding to, most people would read your name and know one of your successful legal career and the work that you do in the courts of Trinidad and Tobago. You've decided, you know what, I'm going to enter active politics. Why?
Yeah, well, that's a question that the vast majority of people that I meet within recent times are asking me. And it's a simple answer. It is about giving public service. It is about, it's a few things combined into that giving public service. You're right, I consider myself to be a young person. and a fairly young person in that, with a very good career. But I don't like the state of the country currently, and I also have a very strong belief that us as young people, it's time for our generation now to get involved. I've never been one to sit back and complain about things, and then if an opportunity comes along to try and fix it, to not take that opportunity. I don't believe, like the vast majority of Trinidad, we should just sit in our armchairs at home and eat our food and complain about the state of the country, and if an opportunity comes to try and fix it or to contribute, that we shouldn't do that.
What was that breaking point for you that you decided I'm going to say, okay, I'm not closing up my practice, but I'm going to dedicate a large portion of my day, my time, and my energy, and let's be real, my finances to this cause. What was it that you decided I've had enough?
Here is the cumulative effect of what has been taking place since May 2010, but also, to be fair, it was a call by Dr. Rowley to come and give public service. And when you're given that call, combined with what I said a short while ago, I'm not going to back down, so it was a very quick decision. He asked me whether I would be prepared to go and give service in the Senate, and I agreed to. And it's just snowballed since then very, very quickly.
Now, you know, I have to ask about that, Mr. Young, because when you think of the Senate, you think of a place of higher discussion. So I would not be surprised that you would volunteer to be a temporary senator. But I was a little surprised when your name was put in the mix for active electoral politics to enter the political guile of the lower house, where the debates are fast, furious, and can be very dirty at times.
Indeed, and one of the tenets you'll hear me speaking about and principles you'll hear me speaking about in and over time is that we have to raise the level. I'm not saying that I agree completely with your analysis of how the lower house is, but part of my contribution I hope to make is to keep trying to raise the level of the bar and trying to take us to a developed world status. And in whatever way I can contribute, you know, I will continue to be who I am, and I'm not going to get down into any gutter with anyone, and I'm going to continue to try and keep it at a very decent level.
Keeping the lower house debates at a decent level. Have you looked at the debates in the lower house recently?
I have.
Now, I do have to ask about, obviously, Patricia McIntosh is the current MP for
she
that
is.
Area. Have you started your campaigning? Because you have been revealed as a candidate for 2015. Have you started working the constituency?
I was fortunate enough to be screened and confirmed as a candidate, and the answer is yes. In fact, just up to yesterday, I was walking through parts of my constituency up in Mova and then come back down into Belmont. So I have been walking the boundaries of my constituency in the Belmont, Mova, Lavantil area to get an idea, first-hand idea, an understanding of the constituency's boundaries, and also to see for myself what the needs and listen to the people are.
And what do you think are the needs of the people? Because, you know, the UNC has been saying that the PNM have routinely rejected their constituencies, and you see them manifest. I mean, you've heard that
correct,
on all
of
their, even their PR machine has said that what we see now is a manifestation of neglect by the PNM. So if you look at a constituency like yours, what are the needs of the people?
Hima, first of all, I'd like to put on the table early o'clock. I can't change the past. No one can change the past. I'm not necessarily accepting what you say the UNC machinery has said. Of course, that's in their political favor to spread that type of propaganda. But firsthand, what I've seen, a lot of it has me very concerned. For example, yesterday I was walking in upper areas of Mova, and they were showing me that actually under the PNM administration, they put in Wasser water means, but since May 2010, they have not had any running water. And we were actually able to hear the air in the lines and see and feel the pain of these people. On another walk in my constituency, the kind of how I saw people living, it really touched a heartstring for me and made me have a deeper resolve that I have to be able to do something.
And okay, so we can say that you empathize with these people, Mr. Young. How do you get it done?
Hima, I am going to walk the talk. I'm going to get it done by hook or crook. I mean, I began thinking they were showing me a playing field at the top of a long line of steps. And it's not a playing field. It's an empty lot of land that they cleared. It was a dirt floor that the children were playing on. But they promised to pitch it, and then they came and put down a stone. And now they can't play on the field anymore because of these stones. And we must be able to, where we have road paving programs. They were recently paving the Beetham that, in my opinion, didn't need to be paved. This is a small 5,000 square foot lot. We must be able to get the pitch there. And these little things make a huge difference in people's lives. I can be a nag. I will nag whoever is the minister that I need to, or the ministers that I need to assist my constituency and get things done.
Now, Mr. Young, you know, the election for 2015, according to all the polls and according to the political analysts, is going to be too close to call. So a young attorney like yourself, with a very lucrative practice, there's a possibility, a 50-50 possibility, you may end up serving as an opposition MP for 5 years. Have you thought about that?
Emma, I have not thought about the PNM not winning the elections. I hear everybody say it's going to be close, but I do not believe for a moment that the right-thinking members and citizens of our society are going to put themselves through another 5 years of what we've seen for the last 4.5 years. So I am prepared to march forward with the troops and to march forward victoriously with the troops.
You know, corruption is one thing that every political party gets licks on, and the government supporters will say, well, the PNM is in no moral position to speak about corruption because corruption is what took the party out of office. Now the UNC is being accused of the same thing. How do you respond to the critics that come and say, well, Mr. Young, the problems didn't start in 2010. What are you going to really do differently?
As I responded a short while ago, I laid that foundation. There is nothing, Hema, that you or I could do about the ills of the past, whether it be under the current government or the past PNM governments or even the past UNC government. We as the young people can just pick up the mantle of responsibility and march our country forward in the direction that we want to and that it needs to go.
Now, you know, I have to ask this question. Everyone can come in with good intentions, and we all have a sense of naivety, and we want to serve country, and we say we're going to make a difference. And when you enter the structure of the public service, that coupled with the pressure of a party, coupled with cabinet pressure and the direction of a political leader or the party philosophy or the government's philosophy, sometimes your individual morals must take a hit, a sacrifice for collective good. Have you thought about how you're going to deal with that?
A lot of people have told me the same thing you just have, Ema. I have always been an individual, and I am not, you know, I can't predict the future, but the only commitment I can give, because I've thought about it long and hard, is to give of my best and to try and stay grounded in the principles that I believe in and the morals that I have grown up with and that level of integrity. And I'm hoping that people understand that going forward in the future. And I have revised my thinking. Yes, of course, I came in, and you use the word naivety, came in with a degree of naivety that I was going to help to change the world. But, you know, being realistic, if I can influence the lives of 10 young people for them to have positive thinking and for them to come forward and assist the country at some level or the other, in my mind, that is an achievement. And it is whatever we can do, whatever Hema Ramkisoon, whatever Stuart Young could do, whatever we can do for the collective good of the country.
Whatever we can do for the collective good. Now, you're going into the lower house as a member of parliament, a representative. And let's be real, this is a PNM safe seat, a very unlikely possibility anyone is going to else but the PNM is going to take this seat. Electoral politics and representing at that level, the MP and the representative for the area, there always seems to be a disconnect on the ground. You go to every constituency and they're going to say, I don't see my MP. I see them only for elections. I need this. I go to the constituency. How does the PNM propose to bridge that gap? And now I'm asking about party level policy.
You would have heard Dr. Rowley say, not only at the recent convention, but also on other occasions. And my understanding is his philosophy is that elected members of parliament must focus more on their constituency. He is going to have a reduced size cabinet. So who is going to sit in that cabinet is up to his ultimate discretion. Yes, I hear it. I've been hearing it in my constituency, but also very much outside of the constituency. And again, all I can do is give the commitment to do of my best. And there's two things I want to just caution going forward. You can never be everywhere at the same time. You're going to have a lot of responsibilities and duties, and you have to find a balance. And then secondly, one of the important things to me, and I was very heartened to hear Dr. Rowley touch on it at his speech in the convention as well, is we need to start moving away from the dependency syndrome that has taken over the country since after independence. So we need to slowly start moving away from that. And part of that is also what you've described.
You think any political party really has the fortitude to do that? And we talk about the gas subsidy, we talk about the welfare programs, we talk about duplication, redundancy. We have over 1,000 social programs listed on a pamphlet from the Ministry of Social Development, many of which are not properly monitored or
Correct.
Streamlined. You really think any party has it in them? When the NAR touched the cost of living allowance and had to deal with the structural adjustment programs, it cost them their political life. Do you think the PNM will do that, has the fortitude to make the tough decisions?
Yes.
Simple answer.
Simple answer.
We're going to take a very short break. When we come back, we're going to continue our discussion with Stuart Young. And a quick breaking news development. If you haven't heard, cricketer Philip Hughes died earlier this morning, 2 days. And this is basically the 25-year-old from the north coast of Wales. He was playing in South Australia. And as you know the story, he was hit in the lower back of the neck by a bouncer. He was taken to hospital in critical condition. He died on Thursday morning. And this is the breaking story in the news at this time. So we will continue to monitor that story. We take a very short break. When we come back, we'll have more for you today with us.
Shop early at Yuffie's chain of fabric stores for the best selection of fashion and home decor fabrics. Your Christmas decorating is easy with the widest selection of curtain panels, comforters, sheet sets, mirrors, and framed art. Yuffie's, for fabrics and home decor.
Fire up your day with the new spicy sriracha chicken at Subway Restaurants. We're talking tender, juicy strips of 100% chicken breast with our signature sriracha sauce for our boldest flavor yet. Then make it yours by choosing your favorite bread and topping it high with lots of fresh veggies and melted cheese. Mm-mm, yes, sriracha. Embrace your bold side with the new spicy sriracha chicken at Subway Restaurants. Subway, eat fresh.
Are you looking for an innovative way to control and monitor your glucose levels? Join the hundreds of people who have switched to the Code-Free blood glucose monitoring system. Code-Free makes it easy to analyze before and after meal glucose results. It has no coding, making it simple to use. 500 test memory with date and time, a 5-second fast test time with only a small blood sample volume needed. And don't even worry about the strips. Code-Free strips are among the most affordable and advanced on the market.
Try Code-Free today by trading in your old glucose machines and get 50% off every Code-Free machine. Available at Pennywise in all leading pharmacies.
Tile Expression, the number one leader in tiles. Christmas tile sale. 12x12, $3.95. 17x17, $7.50. 18x18, $8.50. Porcelain, 24x24, $27.95. Micro milling tin set, $37.95. Tile Expression, Monroe Road, Canupia, near the mosque. Footloose, a new era in fashion. Step into our stores at High Street San Fernando and be dazzled by our excellent customer service with fashion that suits all. Turn your wishes into reality. Footloose, where quality and price pleases every pocket.
Tobago, get ready! November 28th, Island Mix brings to you the hottest Juve band launch to hit Pigeon Point. CX like Roy K, featuring Blacks, Patrice Roberts, Benjai, Olatunji, Talbury, Fata Fox, Fire Empress, and RDX. Purchase tickets at all Penny Savers, Jade Monkey, Barcode, Pablo Supermarket, Highland Grocery Mart, Viewpoint Supermarkets, and Pumpy Barbershop. General admission $300 and VIP $600. Plus, prize for the biggest crew. Check us on Facebook at Island Mix Promotions. Island Mix, we start the carnival.
Par Excellence is the number one housewife's choice in Trinidad and Tobago and is now introducing a new range of products. White rice, parboiled rice, white sugar, brown sugar, and much more. Available at leading supermarkets nationwide.
Single Fathers Association Trinidad and Tobago. There are plenty of us that are trying to find answers and that are maybe bewildered by the legal system and the like, but I can say one thing. I'm not alone, you're not alone, and I guess collectively maybe we can make a difference somehow.
We need Trinidad and Tobago to really appreciate fatherhood, really appreciate fathers. We who are men today were the boys of yesterday who grew up without our fathers. We are the men that are now faced with the challenges to be good fathers. And we need that support from mothers. We need that support from society. It's very hard and very unfortunate to be a father wanting to be in a kid's life and not being able to be there for them, especially when you were that kid just years ago. So we really need fathers. You come out, you step up, no matter what stands against you. Always be in there in your child's life. The mother, the court, anything. Stand up with love for your children.
Yeah, Welcome back, Trinidad and Tobago. I'm Hema Ramkisoon, and this is the Morning Brew. And that breaking news update, if you are just joining us, and this is on the international cricketing front. Philip Hughes has died, and that is the cricketer who was hit by a bouncer during a practice match in Australia. He was not in pain before he passed and was surrounded by family and close friends. As a cricket community, we mourn his loss and extend our deepest sympathies to Philip's family and friends at this incredibly sad time. So there you see exactly what took place. Still in shock. He was 25 years old. Obviously, his career cut short. The Australian Cricketing Council and the international cricketing community continue to mourn what they say is a great loss. A young man gone too soon. So developments there. We are now switching our focus. We're continuing our discussion with one of the newest faces, the PNM, well-known attorney at law, Stuart Young. He said, well, I'm going to start giving back to country, a decision which most people, Mr. Young, you must admit, will be a little shocked at. And, you know, when people think politics and they think entering politics, they think it's an old man's game. It's a game when you have made all of your money and decided, well, at the twilight of my life, I've done what I had to do. I've gotten my career in order. I'm now going to give to country. You have decided to do it a different way. Why?
Hema, life unfolds and it's a journey, and it's one that I've realized you have little control over. I was an advocate of that philosophy of which you described a short while ago, that the better politicians would be those who have the experience, they've already built their financial stability, etc. Now you go back and serve. But now I think it has to be a combination of two, because you need the experience of persons who fall into that category. But we also do need the young blood, the fresh ideas. The world has changed, you know, with the advent of internet and just the availability and accessibility of information. You find young people now broadening their thinking, and that's one of the tenets as well I'm going to be pushing, that it is time that young people be empowered, and it's time that we speak our mind, and it's time that we influence policy going forward.
Why the PNM? You had an option to enter any other political party, and I'm pretty sure that if you approach any political party or even express interest, anybody would want to take you on their side. Why the PNM?
Well, thank you for those words of confidence. I certainly didn't see it that way. Kema, because when I look at it, the PNM has been around from inception. Certainly my exposure to it, there is a great structure in the party. It's a very democratic structure. They have a track record. And also there were certain philosophies and tenets that I could buy into. And Dr. Rowley again touched on some of them at the convention when he talked about morality, etc., integrity, governance. So these are concepts that I could associate with. And the truth is as well, it is a relationship that has been growing and building through my professional practice, being asked to do work for them at a high level from 2004. So, you know, you're exposed to the leadership of the party, et cetera. And it just unfolds and you're asked to do certain, you know, go and sit in the Senate, et cetera.
What do you think makes the PNM so different to the ruling UNC or the COP, as a matter of fact?
Well, it's been around from inception, so it certainly has the party stability. It has a very strong constitution. It's an evolving one, as we saw with the recent internal elections. A political leader giving up his right to veto candidates, and then the one-man, one-vote system in a party. And so I think, and then a difference is there is and has been a lot of policy flowing out of the PNM, you know, regardless of what people say. A lot of what we see as young people in the country, and we would have benefited from in education, for example, comes out of PNM policy and principles.
How do you respond to that statement by the UNC machinery that the PNM, they have neglected their core constituents and their core constituencies? And what do you think this incarnation will do differently to ensure that that is broken?
Well, I think, and it's already been told to candidates going forward, Dr. Rowley is taking it very seriously. You've heard him talk about the philosophy and the policy of moving away from a local government and giving the corporations more power, more control. And certainly when I've been walking in the constituency, that has come home to me, and it makes a lot of sense. Because when I'm asking, well, why can't we get this done? Why can't we fix this playing field? Why can't we pave this road? Why can't we get the running? It's told because we don't have the budget for it. It's told we have to go to this local government, et cetera, et cetera. So that makes sense. So I'm seeing at a policy level decisions being taken that the end result can and hopefully will be that the people on the ground level will benefit more.
Sir Young, you know, I have to keep asking this question about not only your professional, but giving up for politics. And also, you are a rising star in your profession. And entering a cabinet would mean a collective responsibility. Not everybody can be a superstar and hold a superstar position in a cabinet. Have you all had started having that discussions about who's going to hold what position? And I have to ask that because people are going to say, well, I don't know. Maybe it's a skeptic in me that this job has turned me in that. But I don't know why someone in the middle and the highlight of their career will say, I'm going to give it up for country. I mean, I wouldn't do it.
Hima, don't say you wouldn't do it. First of all, to answer your question, there are a lot of presumptions before one can presume entering cabinet. I certainly have made no such presumption. Obviously, it's a question people ask. Ultimately, that will reside in the mind of the political leader and the prime minister as to whether he would want to ask me to serve in cabinet. I have put myself forward to serve. But to answer your question, why? I'm not sure there ever is a right time, right? And yes, it is extremely difficult to give up a very comfortable private life and a very good practice to enter into public service. But it is a commitment and a sacrifice I was prepared to make, because if people don't do it and they don't step forward to do it, then how does the country develop? And I'm not saying for a moment that I believe I am this great person that can change the country, but I'm always one who believes I'll roll up my sleeves and I'll give of my best, and hopefully that contribution would add some positive value.
And how would you deal with the fact that, you know, when you enter, because you look at the partnership, and one of the criticisms that they have received is that the cabinet is too large. And then the political analysts will say, well, it's because you have to balance egos and everybody has to get a piece of the pie.
Why is that the reason?
And this is how it has to be done. So then in the PNM, when you have so many stars, because that's what they say, look at the new faces that we're bringing on. Everyone has something to offer. But in the end, the hierarchy of the cabinet is only a certain way. How then will you deal with that if you're not the superstar of the cabinet?
Well, I don't presume I'm in any setting that I'm a superstar to start with. I think I have a contribution to make, and I will make that contribution to the best of my ability. But I certainly don't hold myself out there for a moment as being a superstar. In fact, you're embarrassing me by using that type of terminology associated with me.
And what do you want Trinidad and Tobago to know about you? You know, when you enter politics and taking out the slogans and the PRs and the campaign team, when people see Stuart Young, what do you want them to know about you?
I want them to say there is a young person who's prepared to take a step forward into the firing line. And once he stays on track, I'm going to support him. He has given up a very comfortable private life for public service. And that is the truth. I have no hidden agendas. I will walk the talk to the best of my ability. But I understand along that journey, there are going to be frustrating moments and factors. I am going to make mistakes because I'm a human being, but bear with me because my heart is in the right place and I'm certainly going to make the best contribution that I can. And I need the support of every member of society.
To be a politician, you must also develop a very thick skin. The media can love you today and hate you tomorrow. They can rip you apart if you get on their wrong side. Have you thought about the fact that you are putting up your entire life, your family, and every single thing that you know in the public eye?
Yes, I have, and it's a very, very frightening thought. But I have faith, and ultimately I believe human beings are decent people. And once they recognize there is no hidden agenda, I am hoping that they will support me. I've received a tremendous amount of support, a lot of questions, similar to what you were asking me this morning. But as I keep saying, I could only put my best foot forward.
Every administration has been accused of launching political witch hunts and manhunts and being vindictive to people that they assume to be supporters of either previous administration or maybe their political enemies. Do you think that the PNM will rise above it and actually enter new politics the way that they have promised? The UNC said they are new politics. They claimed that they are not on witch hunts, but they are to correct the corruption that took place before. What's to say the PNM isn't going to fall and do the same thing?
Well, first of all, it's interesting that the UNC said that, because the first thing they did when they came in office is launch a number of witch hunts. I'm involved in most of the litigation coming out of that for the former board members of state enterprises, etc. And it certainly does feel like a witch hunt. Hima, I think one of the things that this country needs desperately is for there to be a successful prosecution of some white-collar crime. I don't think that the country and a PNM government coming into power should focus on any witch hunting. I certainly have not heard any suggestions of there's going to be witch hunts, etc. I think right now what we're focused on doing is preparing ourselves for when you enter office, that there's an immediate plan that can be rolled out, because we're not in a good place. I'm very concerned about our energy industry. I'm very concerned about, you know, the dropping oil price, but not only dropping oil price, because government is telling us, well, listen, the gas price will rise and it's holding strong, but we're now seeing, as you would see in today's newspapers and as you were interviewing the general manager of TNTech, there is a gas shortage and we need to get proper answers to these things. So there are a lot of things we need to do to move the country forward as opposed to be looking backwards.
10 seconds, your closing comments, Trinidad and Tobago. You have launched your political career. You've inevitably said goodbye to your private practice because the campaign is going to kick off. Elections will be anywhere between May and September of next year. So that's within the next 5 to 9 months. What do you want the country to know?
I want the country to know that this is our time. This is our time to make a difference. This is your time to step forward in whatever role and manner that you can. Going into this election, you need to think long, you need to think hard, you need to think sensibly, and you need to think what is the best thing for your children going forward. Make the right choices, and I think it's obvious that what you've seen in the last 4.5 years cannot be the right choice.
We're going to take a very short break. When we come back, yet one of the... But he was there from the inception. He has some interesting thoughts about Mr. Manning's possible re-entry into politics. We'll tell you more about that. Stay with us.
Hi, I'm Shivana. When I heard the news from my school teacher, I was shocked beyond words. None of this would have been possible without God, my parents and family, all my hard-working teachers, and of course at the Guardian SCA practice test. I use that every Wednesday since I was in Standard 4 and made sure I checked the results on the Friday. Parents, I would encourage you strongly to get the Guardian SCA every Wednesday for your child and help them achieve their true potential.
The SCA practice test, free in your Wednesday Guardian.
Debt Recovery and Administrative Services Limited, the leader in debt collections for over 15 years. Our advanced technological approach continues to make us number one. Call or visit us online for more information. Because when things don't go as planned, we are here to keep you afloat.
Even as we expect that everything changes in time, there's a magic to the way Shagaramas is transforming into one of the region's most idyllic investment and entertainment destinations. Perfectly located on the picturesque northwestern peninsula, the potential of this breathtaking landscape is being realized through the vision of the Shagaramas Development Authority, CDA. Explore the adventure that is rapidly becoming fabulous Shagaramas. The excitement, the thrills, the romance of the boardwalk. This is your invitation to a whole new world of opportunity. Shagaramas, somewhere close to magic.
Hi, I'm James Saunders. That's right, the anchor man with a breaking news story that takes you beyond pigtails, quality, barbecue, deprivation. Even as a chef, I have experienced this, but no more.
As a world-renowned Olympic medalist, I have had unadulterated barbecue privilege, and it weighs heavily on my conscience, which is why I've joined Wendy's Barbecue Pork for TNT cause to help fight barbecue pork inaccessibility.
Today, Wendy's have delivered where others failed by bringing truly mouth-watering barbecue pulled pork to the Trinbagonian market. Barbecue.
Pulled.
Pork.
Wendy's Barbecue
for TNT. Together, we can help the barbecue pork deprived.
Wendy's. Now that's better.
It's Santa's big super Christmas sale in November. We want you to remember. Up to 60% off in our new basement sale. Lots of perfumes, gifts, ornaments, Christmas decorations, flowers, hair, nails, and costume jewelry, handbags, scarves, and more. Some items buy one and pay half price for a second item. So come and get the best for less. 70 to 72 High Street, San Fernando, and 8 to 10 Point de Pere Road, San Fernando. Remember, at Santa's, our duty is to care for your beauty.
Join the Guardian Neediest Cases Fund for a family movie night at the premiere of Annie, Movie Town, Port of Spain on Tuesday, December 16th. Take a donation, $125. The movie starts at 7 p.m. Exciting, door prizes to be won. Get your tickets at all Guardian offices, St. Vincent Street, Port of Spain, Mid-Center Mall, Chaguanas, High Street, San Fernando, or online at www.guardian.co.tt. So come on out, bring the family, and let's enjoy a great movie for a great cause.
Welcome back, Trinidad and Tobago. I'm Hemaram Kisun, and this is The Morning Brew. While joining us on set now, Ferdy Ferreira. He was with the PNM since its inception. Today, we're hearing that a former political leader and a former founder, one of the I guess you can consider him to be founding, forming the foundations of this party in terms of what we know it today, Patrick Manning, may be entering the political fray in 2015. One of the members who's been there since the beginning, Ferdy Ferreira, says, well, I don't know about that. That shouldn't be the direction that we should be going at this time. Mr. Ferreira, good morning. Thank you for joining us.
Morning, Eamon. Morning to the listeners.
When you first heard that there's a possibility Patrick Manning may be entering active politics in 2015, what did you think about?
Well, certainly, the first thing that came to my mind is something that I referred to in the Express. And it took me back to an article I wrote a couple of years ago on the Huber syndrome. There are two ways about it. Manning, like so many other leaders, have become a victim of the Huber syndrome. There is a book that I brought with me here, In Sickness and in Power. Don't know if you ever came into contact with it.
No.
Written by a former minister in the James Callaghan government and also a medical practitioner. It's a compilation of the behavior of world leaders over the last 100 years that includes Theodore Roosevelt, David Lloyd George, Benito Mussolini, Adolf Hitler, and it comes right back down to Margaret Thatcher, Robert Mugabe, Ronald Reagan, Francis Mitterrand, George Bush, Ariel Sharon. It's a compilation of the behavior and how they reacted, having stayed in power either too long or were unable to control. In one of my articles some years ago, I said political leaders must be contained. You don't attempt to control them, but they must be contained. Now, Mr. Manning, having said that, Mr. Manning has given the 43 best years of his life to this country.
Mm-hmm. And no one can deny his contribution to the political landscape and to nation building.
Correct. It has been done at great sacrifice to his family and his health. Mr. Manning is now 68 years of age. And one of the things that I've looked at in checking the political history of this country is what I would describe as a level of unkindness. Political leaders in Trinidad and Tobago since independence have been all victims of medical problems. Mm-hmm. Dr. Williams became chief minister at the age of 45 on the 24th of September 1956. He died on the 29th of March 1981 from what they said was a diabetic coma. At the age of 69, he didn't even accomplish his three score and ten. He was followed by Mr. George Chambers, who became prime minister at the age of 60. Served for 5 years, died at 69. We are not too sure, He was followed by Mr. Robinson.
Robinson came after Chambers.
Robinson assumed the prime ministership at the age of 57. He was shot in his leg at the age of 61 and never fully recovered his health. Died at 84 in a wheelchair.
Why do you think his name has entered the political fray today?
Yes, no, four. That's Mr. Robinson. He comes now to Mr. Pandey.
Mr. Pandey was the next one.
61. a victim of cardiovascular disease, had major surgery in Trinidad. And we come to Mr. Manning, who became the leader, the prime minister, at 45. 40, he was the youngest, I think it was.
He was.
Because today he's almost. There's very little difference in terms of our current prime minister doesn't enjoy the best of health. We know that. I think we're aware of it. She's diabetic.
Let's not talk about her health issues. But the issue is Mr. Manning at this point in time. Now, what do you make of his decision? Well, he has said nothing. He said all questions will be referred to Mustafa Abdulhamid.
But it's unfortunate, and to my mind, when you have friends like Mustafa Hamid, you don't need enemies.
This is not about Mustafa Abdulhamid. It's about
what I'm saying is here is a former government. You can't escape. He's a former government minister. And he comes and makes a statement like that. One, he doesn't represent the constituency. Two, such a statement must have made. Mr. Manning must have had some. Nobody's going to fool me that. So I'm not sure what you were saying. Mm. Having served this country, there are two significant questions that this country must ask in terms of Mr. Manning, desire or attempts, whatever they have with you. One, what at 68 years of age, after 43 years, as I said, San Fernando East has had two representatives. Gerald Montano, 1956 to 1971. Patrick Manning from 1971 to 2015. 43 years. Leader of the opposition, member, he served in almost every parliamentary secretary I knew when he came in. Fundamental question, what else does Mr. Manning have to this country, have to offer this country? Question number two, what do we expect from the return of Mr. Manning?
What do you expect by the return of Mr. Manning? Do you expect
personally, there's nothing else to be that Mr. Manning can offer this country. Mr. Manning has given tremendous service. He floated the dollar. He monetized the gas, the Ban Lara Promenade. There are several things. Mr. Manning has served this country well. He's a performer. His 2020 vision is one of the most excellent documents ever presented in this country. So there is very little, if anything at all, that Mr. Manning have to offer this country. As far as I'm concerned, Mr. Manning's number one priority now is the restoration of his health.
You think he's being encouraged to do this, or is it simply testing the waters?
Well, it comes back, my dear, to the hubris sinful. And I brought a copy that I will leave with you of this characteristics of it, the signals of it. And this assumption by leaders that it reaches the stage that Tony Blair, not only a brilliant scholar, but a very good prime minister, when questioned on the Iraq War, his response that I am not, and the effect it was having on the electorate and the citizens, his answer was, I am not accountable to these people. I am accountable to history and God. That's where the hubris steps in. And as I said, I would advise every active politician and every young person, like Mr. Young, I showed him this book outside, who's aspiring to become, to read this book. It was given to me by my late friend, Carl Terence Hudson Phillip.
But you know, when you look at
and this is something that you have to deal with all the time. As soon as you start over glorifying your leaders, as we are witnessing today, nearly every member of parliament, particularly in the ministerialist government, cannot complete the presentation without a reference to the prime minister. I'm sure you have observed
it. Yeah, but even in the opposition, they do that too. It's a Caribbean. It's a Caribbean thing. You listen to any of the regional governments.
It is extremely. I don't understand if they understand the extent of the monstrosity that they create. We create, and I make no apologies for what I'm going to say here. We create it, Dr. Williams, the beloved Dr. Williams, my mentor, my political father. We created a political monster. And yet in the late half, one of the things that was responsible for my leaving was the undated letter with Carl Hudson Phillip. Mm-hmm. Chambers didn't have much time, he had 5 years. Young Mr. Manning came in almost by accident. we created another political monster. We saw it with Mr. Pandey. And these are the things to me that the younger people have to look at.
Fidi, are you simply afraid of this, of the inevitable fight between the Manning supporters and Rowley supporters? And
if you read my article yesterday in the Mirror, I assume you might have.
I did.
Then you will know that PNM has no fear. PNM has survived Carl Hudson Phillip. They survived Robinson. They survived 20 years defeat in Tobago. And if you read it, you will understand the sustainability, stability. 24th of January next year, 59. So Manning or no Manning, there's no threat to the PNM. The PNM is a solid, constructive, articulate, democratic political organization. They will survive Manning, they survive Williams, it survived Chambers, it survived it survived Robinson, it survived Hudson Phillip.
So we're going to go straight to the 7 o'clock newscast. And when we come back, we'll continue our discussion with Fidi Ferreira. He was a man who was there from the beginning and intends to stay till the end. And he's saying at this time, Mr. Manning really should not be entering the race. We take a very short... Well, we're going to go to the news, and I'll see you after the news. Stay with us.
Good morning, I am Akash Samaru with your 7 a.m. news here on CNC3 and the TBC Radio Network. An 84-year-old Karapi Chima man will appear in court today after being charged for sexually assaulting his three granddaughters. The girls are said to be ages 8, 10 and 14. According to police, the girls had been complaining to their grandmother for some time, but she did not believe them. What makes this incident even more tragic is that inquiries revealed that the grandfather allegedly sexually assaulted the 14-year-old when she was 10. He then allegedly started with the 10-year-old when she was 8, and according to the girls, recently began sexually assaulting the 8-year-old girl. Police say they found out when the 14-year-old girl informed her teacher. CNC3 understands all three girls were medically examined. Up to late last night, charges were being written up against him, and counselling was being arranged for the children. Petrotrin is accusing the Oilfield Workers Trade Union of being unreasonable during wage negotiations and not understanding the tough economic times that are facing the company. Petrotrin says due to its financial loss this year, which is in excess of $345 million, it must undergo cost management. It says it was also downgraded by the financial rating agencies to the lowest level of investment grade. Petrotrin says as such, its current proposal does not include any increase to the base salary of workers. Petrotrin says due to the drop in oil prices also, this must be done if the company is to survive. It says it received a revised proposal from the OWTU, which it will review and respond to today. Opposition Chief Whip and PNN Deputy Political Leader Mullin MacDonald says if Patrick Manning decides to offer himself a screening as a candidate for San Fernando East, he will be given due consideration. Speaking with reporters yesterday, she says the party intends to offer the best possible slate of candidates for the 2015 general elections.
When they selected Mr. Manning, and Mr. Manning went through the screening process, I believe that they are satisfied, the constituents would be satisfied with who was selected, and they voted resoundingly for Mr. Manning. And from where I sit, I think that Mr. Manning represented his constituents very well, very well. Who will determine whether he is so, if he continues, would be his constituents and the screening committee.
And a tragedy in the sports world as Philip Hughes, the Australia Test batsman struck on the head by a ball 2 days ago, has died. The 25-year-old passed away after injuries sustained while batting for South Australia against New South Wales at the Sydney Cricket Ground on Tuesday. Hughes, who had played 26 tests, collapsed on the pitch after being hit by a ball from pace bowler Sean Abbott as he attempted a pull shot. The batsman, who was wearing a protective helmet, was rushed to the city's St. Vincent Hospital, where he underwent surgery and was being monitored in the intensive care unit. Cricket Australia confirmed on its official website that he had been struck on the back lower left side of the head, and the team doctor confirmed that he had suffered a severe head injury. He later confirmed the player never regained consciousness. And that was your 7 a.m. news here on CNC3 and the TBC Radio Network. Let's take a quick break, then rejoin Hema Ramkisoon on The Morning Brew.
Welcome back, Trinidad and Tobago. I'm Ram Kasuna, and this is The Morning Brew. And we're continuing our discussion with Felipe Barrero. He has some interesting thoughts about Patrick Manning's the possible announcement, because Mr. Manning has not confirmed, nor has he's distanced himself from the statements that were made at the constituency level meeting. What advice do you have for Mr. Manning this morning, Mr. Barrero?
Well, my advice, if I had to advise Mr. Manning, my advice would be his number one priority, restoration of his health. As I said earlier on, he has given the best 43 years of his life to the service of the nation, a great sacrifice, both of his health and, I imagine, the neglect of his family. Restoration of his life. And while you're on that, I didn't conclude Mr. Pandey was saved by the party. In 2010.
Well, he was basically ousted.
Look at it. Mr. Pandey is
party rejected it.
Mr. Pandey is 1 year younger than I am. He's 81, I'm 82. And I met him recently. And we had a wonderful evening at Trotters with his family. And I say, here is a man that is now enjoying his retirement, having have his health restored. And I would like to suggest, rather than Mr. Manning waiting for it, that his priority number one, restoration of your health. Priority number two, enjoy your retirement and let us have the benefit of your memoirs. And in whatever way, if you so desire, to continue to assist the party in an advisory capacity. The most significant thing of Mr. Manning now is his legacy. And unlike so many other leaders in history, who have made tremendous contribution, not only to the country, but to the international community, and have done in the final irreparable damages to the legacy, I think it would be Mr. Manning's best interest. I can't tell him what to do. Certainly, as a political activist who have been around for a long time, it would be in his best interest now. Proceed as restoration of his health.
Why do you think this is even being considered? You think somebody's setting him up, or are they testing the waters to determine Dr. Rowley's popularity?
No.
The party?
Apparently, that's why I brought these two books, and there are several quotations. Mr. Manning is a victim of hubris.
And you think this is all his doing?
It's his. He don't know how to leave the stage like so many others. When they asked at one time, somebody told Churchill grandson, tell him you're the greatest man in the world, and he said yes. Read it, it's all documented, I didn't say it. Tony Blair said that when they told him about the effect it was, he said that is, you know, the issue is history and God. When that steps in, when these signals, and I will send you a copy of these signals as outlined by Prophet David Owen, they're all here. This has nothing to do with Mr. Mustafa, except that it's unfounded. He should have been asked to do that. Mr. Manning has not yet denied it.
He's not denied it, nor has he confirmed it.
No, he don't. The mere idea he has not yet. He said on a previous occasion that he was bowing out. Yes. This was his opportunity to say, I have not discussed this with the former minister, and this is not my thinking. There is absolutely, I'm not going to be part of any stupidity to encourage this. There is absolutely no justifiable reason for Mr. Manning attempt to re-enter into active politics.
He has
served us extremely well. He has left a legacy. He's not enjoying the best of his health. So he knows better than anybody else, and those around him, if in fact they really love
him. But, you know, if he goes before the screening committee, you think he should actually put himself up for screening? And can a screening committee in the People's National Movement tell a man who has served this country, who has led this country as prime minister and political leader of this party, can they actually
tell him no? That you asked that, because the press, the media is going to have a field day when he comes to Ballysay House, and he has to exit that car and climb those staircases. There's no elevator there. The media is going to have a field day, which I think Mr. Manning could do without. And what is he going to do? Carry Mr. Mustafa there to answer the questions? I mean, this could be so embarrassing for a man who has served this country so loyally and has given this country the best years of his life to go out with the media there, with all these modern look, seeing me almost crawling out of a car. They cannot. He is not as mobile as he would like to be, you know that.
But they say that he served his constituents. That's what the PR of the constituency office said yesterday on my show, Mr. Ferrero.
Churchill served England, you know, and he was, you know that. So Winston Churchill served England and the world, and he was deposed, simply deposed off, shortly after the end of the war, right? I'm sure you know that as well as I do.
I do. But Winston Churchill still is one of my favorite characters in history as it relates to political leaders, and a very prophetic man and poetic as
when
well.
When the time comes?
The time comes for all of us, I guess.
All of us.
It just has to determine when
and
it is.
And I mean, I am in the departure alone. The only thing I'm flying, Liat. Leave the islands anytime.
We take a very short break. When we come back, we'll have more for you. This is The Morning Brew. Stay with us.
Couldn't make out what you told me, swear you did not say a word. Now go leave your mark upon the world. If there was one thing that you can take from this, just know when there's nothing more to say, just let your life take it from here.
Attention all caterers, wholesalers, and retailers. Beaver Distributors Limited introduces our brand new styrofoam products. Low prices on our superior brand personal care items, cleaning products, paper products, and our wholesale sizes of food items. Come in today at Beaver Distributors Limited. Superior quality at superior low prices.
Young man, you lost something. Come on, Fifi. So stressed.
Thank you.
With BioStrat food supplement, you stay fit.
BioStrat for energy throughout your lifetime. Available at pharmacies and fine health food stores nationwide.
For 20 years, Value Optical has cared for your eyes. And we want to celebrate the moment with you. Get 25% off your eyeglasses as our annual frame festival makes its way to a branch near you. With the latest styles and designer brands like Nine West, Converse, D&G, and Boss. Isn't it time you made your eyes happy? Call 800-2020 to schedule an appointment today. Or see the press for details. Value Optical, caring for your eyes.
Is your skin ready for carnival? Time to visit True Complexion Unisex MediSpa, sole distributor for Oxygen Botanicals, infusing time-released oxygen to rejuvenate cells and repair your skin, and is made for our skin types and climate. And our Vitality Institute Medical Peel is the industry leader in non-surgical skin resurfacing. For more information on our innovative products and to meet with our certified medical esthetician, contact us, True Complexion. Your true skin awaits.
Dig into the deliciously sophisticated taste of Wendy's with our new smoked Gouda chicken, layered with flavors of caramelized onion sauce and Dijon aioli, all atop a buttery brioche bun. It's time to bring your taste buds to attention with our new smoked Gouda on brioche. Something so Gouda is only around for a limited time. So try one today. Wendy's. Now that's better. Available at all locations nationwide.
It's a two-day mega scratch and dent sale this Friday and Saturday at Brand Source. Everything at factory prices. Everything must go. Brand Source mega scratch and dent sale this Friday and Saturday. Brand Source number 121 Monroe Road, Kunopia. 693-2421.
Look out! Every weekday on Crime Watch, you can now double your winnings.
Double your winnings!
In the Guardian Crime Watch Lucky Key Promotion. Look for your lucky key at the back of the Guardian each day. Watch Crime Watch at 6 p.m. on CNT3 to find out if you have the lucky key. You now have a chance to double your winnings. Remember to buy your Guardian and watch Crime Watch at 6 p.m. on CNT3 to find out if you have the lucky key for a chance to double your winnings. Exclusively on Crime Watch on CNT3. See The Guardian for details. Details.
Taste Challenge is brought to you in part by...
Welcome back, Trinidad and Tobago. Restorative justice is a theory of justice that emphasizes repairing the harm caused or revealed by criminal behavior. It is best accomplished through comparative processes that include all stakeholders. Now, Trinidad and Tobago is on a drive to ensure that we have restorative as opposed to redistributive justice. Practices and programs reflecting restorative purposes will respond to crime by identifying and taking steps to repair harm involving all stakeholders and transforming the traditional relationship between communities and their government in responding to crime. Some of the programs and outcomes typically identified with restorative justice include victim-offender mediation conferencing, circles, victim assistance, ex-offender assistance, restitution, community service, and that is basically an explanation as to what is restorative justice and the type of justice administered in Trinidad and Tobago. Joining us on set now, we have a member of the Trinidad and Tobago Police Service and also Adrian Alexander, the Prison Service, sorry, and Adrian Alexander, and we're talking restorative justice at the conference that's taking place and our victim's handbook. Good morning, gentlemen. Thank
good
you for joining
you,
us.
Good morning to you, viewers.
Now, we just had a definition of restorative justice, and Adrian, maybe I can start with you. We look at the type of justice administered, and I know that there's a drive to think or hope that we can achieve restorative justice, but what exactly is happening now? The analysis of what is taking place, would you describe it as restorative justice or redistributive?
Well, essentially the conference that you made reference to took place last month on the 13th and 14th of October. So at the level of the Ministry of Justice, they're looking at the development of a national policy on restorative justice, engaging local stakeholders, Caribbean persons who have had greater experience in restorative justice, such as in Jamaica, where they've had a victim's charter since 2006, an entire policy on restorative justice, whereby it runs parallel to their criminal justice system for a number of years. We are at our, I would say, middle steps, in the sense that in 1998, we had a Community Mediation Act. We have community mediation centers which apply restorative justice principles in attempting to resolve conflicts between individuals. We've had that from 1998 up to 2003, a little changeover, and then the community mediation is back again. Therapeutic jurisprudence is something that is being expanded in our criminal justice system. We know of the drug courts, mm-hmm. We know of the Bail Boys program, we know of the victim impact statement. That has been introduced in our criminal justice system for a number of years. His Excellency, when he sat on the bench, actually was the first judge to allow victim impact statements in the courtroom, whereby victims are able to express the full scope of harm that has impacted them and their loved ones in the aftermath of a crime, and how they believe that harm needs to be repaired.
You know, it's interesting that we're having this conversation because we're looking at the aftermath of Ferguson internationally, and we look at how victims feel, or the families actually feel aggrieved by failures of the justice system. So when we talk about restorative justice, are we talking about a justice for the family members, or getting everyone on the same page to understand that we must just all move forward?
That actually is an excellent component and byproduct of restorative justice. Make reference to Ferguson, and immediately I'm thinking of even greater systems of injustice. In the aftermath of apartheid, for instance, the Truth and Reconciliation Commissions sought to bring healing and closure for the family members of victims who had simply vanished. You know, they would have been arrested by the police and they were never heard of again. In the aftermath of Rwanda and the genocide there, the Gacaca courts were a community court structure that were utilized to address the hundreds of thousands of persons who had been arrested as a result of their part in the genocide. So restorative justice is broad. Some people hear restorative justice and they think of mediation.
And they think of forgiveness, and they think of a tap on your hand and go ahead and we will do it.
And nothing is further from the truth. Simply because restorative justice requires an offender to admit his guilt. So that is a huge step forward. Rather than playing the adversarial game and pleading not guilty and say, well, you prove your case, an offender says, look, I am responsible for the actions. I committed the act, and I am willing to bear the consequences of that, own up to that, seeking to make amends, whether it is an apology, whether it is to make reparation to the victim's families, as the case may be. And the community also needs to be healed. As you made reference to Ferguson, there is a dire need for communities to be healed, because communities feel as though they have been victimized by the uneven manner of not only of the justice system, but of law enforcement and its selective enforcement of the law in certain instances.
Now, Carlos, you are in the heart of it all. You get to see whether or not the hardened criminals, but you know, off air, I asked you the question, how do we talk restorative justice in a system that is so broken, in a system where realistically someone can sit in remand yard and wait for 5 to 10 years for a trial date? The system itself is not congruent with the principles of restorative justice.
Well, certainly, Hema, these are the challenges that the prison service has faced. As you know, this concept of restorative justice went back to the Batiste Task Force inquiry that was commissioned in 2002. And successive administrations have sought to present implementation format for restorative justice. And certainly the challenges that we face on the ground in terms of physical infrastructure plan, the need to have new rules, the need to have a system of parole, all of these factors have mitigated against the successful implementation. But be that as it may, we have recognized that there is great possibilities that restorative justice and its implementation portends for justice in Trinidad and Tobago. And the Ministry of Justice, as the champion agency since 2010, has been moving full speed ahead to seek, while they at the same time, to bring about the infrastructural changes. As you will well know, some of these have been well highlighted by the Devsaran Committee's report. Mm-hmm. But certainly the ministry is moving on two fronts. Certainly to bring the physical plant and to treat with the other hard issues, as we say, but to also look at soft side issues. And certainly restorative justice, the implementation of a reintegrative penal policy model and the shared responsibility model of correction are the three soft side approach.
How far off are we to that?
Certainly, we have to first have the legislative agenda, and this is where it's at. The ministry held the conference on the 13th and the 14th of October to get a wide spectrum of viewpoints, and the next step is to draft a policy. Certainly, what is being attempted is to add to the due process of Trinidad and Tobago an alternative layer, another layer that will seek to bring justice across the society and seek to enhance the concept of public safety as we are looking towards.
Now, we're talking also about a victim's handbook as well?
That is correct.
What exactly is it?
The victim's handbook is actually a document. It's going to be available in soft copy as well as hard copy from various police stations, NGOs, which work with victims of crime. And it gives the victim an idea of what will transpire throughout the criminal justice system, who provides services directed to assist victims, whether they are psychosocial or even financial services. So from the state perspective, you have the Criminal Injuries Compensation Board. You also have the victim and witness support unit, and the services that they provide. From civil society, there is the Victim Support Foundation, which provides services to victims of violent crime, including accompanying them to court throughout the entire process. Rape Crisis Society, Coalition Against Domestic Violence. These are some of the agencies which are listed in the victim handbook, so that victims can know where to go for what type of help, how to make contact with them, what to expect at various stages of the criminal justice system. And it's a step forward, Hema, but we've been having discussions with the Ministry of Justice and our partner agency, Victim Support Foundation, towards a victim's charter for Trinidad and Tobago, where we identify the rights that victims have in the criminal justice system, even in terms of how victims interact with the media, mm-hmm. you know. And that is something that we're looking at approaching in early 2015.
Carlos, how do you propose that, you know, we actually just fix the system to get people to not only embrace the concept of restorative justice, but to get those who are charged with the responsibility of implementing it to understand the need to do it now?
Well, certainly it starts from seeing what are the benefits that restorative justice portends for our justice system. Adrian has spoken to the wide lengths other jurisdictions have implemented it within their systems, and they have seen improvement in terms of the victims, certainly increased rehabilitation for offenders. Certainly to say that is not to say that we're not required to do the physical infrastructural changes. certainly the implementation of a system of parole, the coming into force of a new set of prison rules, all of these are going to have to be done at the same time, simultaneously, as it were, because we're coming from perhaps very far back. But it's a challenge that I'm sure the Ministry of Justice, as the champion agency, and of course the Commissioner of Prisons and the Prisons Executive, is committed to, and certainly to try new things, because we cannot say that we have problems and not prepared to try alternative strategies to bring about success. The restorative justice is a step in the right direction, we think.
Closing comments from Nan Tobago.
There's hope. Restorative justice has been shown to lead to a £1 billion saving over 10 years for the entire criminal justice system. It gives 85% satisfaction to victims who take part in it. 80% of offenders who take part express satisfaction, and there have been shown to be between 15 and 25% reduction in reoffending as a result of persons participating in restorative justice processes. So benefits across the board, financial, emotional, psychosocial, and for the community.
Benefits across the board. We take a very short break. When we come back, we'll have more for you. This is The Morning Brew. I'm Hema Ranke. Soon, stay with us.
Tech Thursday is brought to you by Blink V Mobile.
Good morning and welcome to your Tech Thursday segment here on CNC3. Have you ever found yourself swapping between your devices? Well, if you did and you're like me, you're familiar with the confusion and time wasting. But Logitech may have found the solution with their Bluetooth multi-device keyboard, the K480. The keyboard can use up to three devices regardless of its computing platform. Now, you can work on a report on your computer and with the flick of the easy switch dial, respond to a message on your smartphone or type a tweet on your tablet. Now, how cool is that? And get this, the integrated cradle holds your phone or tablet at just the right angle for you to read while you type. The keyboard is compatible for PC, Windows 7, Windows 8 or later, Mac, Mac OS X or later, Chrome OS, iPad or iPhone, iOS 5 and Android tablet or smartphone, and only $49.99 US or roughly around $300 TT. It uses two AAA batteries with a battery life of 2 years. The device also has a Bluetooth range of up to 30 feet and comes in either black or white. So techies, what do you think about this invention? Will you buy it? It seems like pretty soon even the simplest gadget around us will evolve. Well, that wraps up this week's Tech Thursday. Until next time, techies.
Tech Thursday was brought to you by Blink V Mobile.
I couldn't make out what you told me, swear you did not say a word. Now go leave your mark upon the world. If there was one thing that you can take from this, just know when there's nothing.
What's this, you ask? Oh, it's just a
spreadsheet smashing,
hedge trimming,
dog walking,
weekend awaying,
show boating,
gravity defying,
tree chopping,
glucose acknowledging,
energy fueling,
barbecuing,
glucose refueling,
engine revving,
crowd surfing,
home commuting,
crocodile wrestling,
explosion ignoring,
awesome kind of energy.
Whatever you do, do it with energy.
Tobago Hotspots magazine is your guide for everything Tobago. Find the best hotels, fantastic restaurants, ideal shopping locations, and event schedules. We also show you the gorgeous beaches, romantic locations, and much more. Get your exclusive Tobago Hotspots magazine every second Saturday each month in your Guardian.
Visit the Redemption Worship Center of St. Thomas Village, Chaguanas, a place where miracles happen and people are blessed. With Pastors Keith and Radhika Ramdas, Sundays 9 a.m. worship and Thursdays 7 p.m. Bible study. To register for our vocal and music classes, as well as our high-impact leadership and ministry training program, call 672-4262, 683-2031, or email redemption@tsdt.net.tt. Empowering people, transforming nations.
Hosides invites all shrimp lovers to enjoy the mouth-watering shrimp dishes. New on the menu, dal, rice, and curry shrimp. Go ahead, ask about our new tamarind sauce. Hosides Roti Shop, Trinidad's premier roti shop. Arriba, Tunapuna, Sawa, Port of Spain.
Sanjeevani for Life introduces Neurofactor Plus, an all-natural treatment for the entire central nervous system. Neurofactor Plus is used to treat Alzheimer's disease, Parkinson's, insomnia, neuropathy, high blood pressure, stroke, depression, stress, chronic body pains, and much more. Visit them at 441 Old Southern Main Road, Chase Village, Chaguanas, or call 665-5433. Sanjeevani for Life, Ayurvedic and Body Care Clinic. Your health is your wealth.
Homeland Furnishings, your trendsetters for unique, one-of-a-kind items. Large variety, exclusive quality furniture. View our new amazing range of outdoor furnishings. Everything to make your home sparkle and your neighbor jealous this Christmas. Beautiful beds and comforter sets. Classy and interesting vases. Plus fabric land, storage land, kids land, rugs and more. Homeland Furnishings Piarco Plaza, where being unique doesn't cost a lot. Open on Sundays.
Get it at Home Express and outfit your home with the best brands at the best prices. Home Express, where no one does it better.
Is that to be flies, that to be roaches, that to be mosquitoes? That to the spider, that to the ants, that to flee on your clothes. That to the weevil and maribonta, that the trail you tread. That to the sandfly, that to campania, that to bugs in your bed. Now is the time to clean up the mess. Is that to all insect pests?
That is now available in three formulations, citronella, lemon and original.
That killed them dead!
Back Trinidad and Tobago, Hema Ramki Sul, and this is the Morning Brew. Well, we're talking about Panin Larosa, and joining us, Laura Lee and Kurt. Good morning. How are you both?
Good morning. Wonderful.
Now, my first question to you. Let's start with you, Laura Lee. Panin Larosa. What exactly is it?
Well, as the name says, it's pan. It's in Santa Rosa in Arima. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, basically, that's what it's all about. Pan.
It's a celebration of the country's steel pan. And Kurt. Mm-hmm. This is not the first year that you're having this event.
This is the fourth year.
So we're going into 4 years, and every year, obviously, you must make some changes to ensure that we keep it really nice. What are you doing differently this year?
Well, this year, one of the additions would be the stage would be the pans will be playing on an elevation. Mm-hmm. Also, it would be amplified. Also, there will be a big screen for those who don't want to come close up. Can now stay back and look at it on the big screen and listen to it amplified rather than being up next to the band itself when it's playing.
And if I may add, there also we have singers that are singing along with the band this year. Previous years we did not have that. We have singers like Marilyn and Poser, so that will be singing along. The bands will play like one of their tunes and they will sing along with the bands as well. So that's an addition this year.
Now, this event is from the minister's office, the MP's office,
yeah.
Right?
Yes.
So is it just pan music all day? Or what else can you expect?
Well, it starts around 4 in the afternoon and goes till midnight, so it's
not just like, it's a mixture of music. It's a mixture of Christmas music, it's a mixture of calypso music. They might add in a little pop in there, so it's basically just a variety of music. But, you know, it's the kick off the Christmas season, as well as what you can hope for next year, the carnival season. So basically it's just, you know, everything wrapped up in one.
Now the bands include the Arima Angel Harps, mm-hmm. the NLCB, and also a number, the PCS Silver Stars, Cal Invaders, Massey Trinidad also. So you have a lot of bands.
Yes.
Yeah. Top bands.
The top bands.
A lot
bands.
Of top bands.
So the event showcases seven of the best steel bands accompanied by local artists such as Miss Marilyn Williams and Poza. Uh-huh. And, you know, security and not only entertainment, but refreshments and security are a big thing. Parking is also a major
definitely
thing.
Well, we liaise with the police officers, security. We have our own securities as well as we liaise with officers. There's Rail Line Boulevard, which is where the event is located. There's a police station right there on spot, you know. And we liaise with them on the day of the event. They make sure the area is secure. They help us with parking. So basically, it's a very safe event.
And what are you looking forward to most? Because, you know, sometimes you tell the organizers have the little kind of tricks that they want, and they know exactly what to look forward to. What are you looking forward to most, Arlie?
Honestly, the event was initiated by the Member of Parliament for Arima just to create a better Arima, just to bring something fresh and new to Arima, you know, because his job in being there is to, you know, enhance Arima, and that was one of the reason behind creating such a, you know, an event like this. So, and has really done a lot for patrons there. For the past, 4 years? No, 3 years. We've had an overwhelming amount of patrons, people passing through. You know, it has welcomed people from abroad. So it has really, really, really done a lot in terms of enhancing Arima, especially bringing the traditional, our national instrument home. So, you know.
What do you want? What's the one thing you want Trinidad and Tobago to know about this festival? Because this is really about getting them to come out.
Well, it's on Saturday, mm-hmm. 29th. We hope everyone come out to it on Saturday, and there'll be a lot in store. We have a bar, we have a very huge food court.
Full stock bar. There's festive foods on sale.
And there's a lot of parking because Santa Rosa Heights, you know, the roads are very wide, and there's a lot of parking.
And the event is throughout Lime Boulevard, so it's like a strip. A long strip.
A whole party strip in Santa Rosa.
Yes. Scenic party strip, huh?
I have to remember that. I have to make sure. It's the fourth year that they're having the event. And you see some, as we go to break, we have some footage there from the event last year. And this is what you can expect. So you're taking the event in. This is the fourth year that they're going to be out in the Pan in the Roof. So we take a very short break. When we come back, we'll have more for you. Stay with us.
Woodville is clearing out one of its warehouses for good. Prices like never before. Warehouses must be cleared. Five-piece bedroom set from $5,995. Seven-piece dining sets from $1,995. Living room sets from $2,995. And many more items priced to clear.
Footloose, a new era in fashion. Step into our stores at High Street San Fernando and be dazzled by our excellent customer service with fashion that suits all. Turn your wishes into reality. Footloose, where quality and price pleases every pocket.
Chic Leisure Limited, leading manufacturers of vermicelli, split piece powder, greaseproof paper, manufacturers of a variety of paper and plastic bags, bags for french fries, sandwiches, popcorn, supermarket stores, and more. Whatever your needs, trust Chic Leisure Limited for quality products.
Party Central, where all your dreams can come true this Christmas, with gifts for everyone, glassware and candy bowls and mugs for all. And don't forget your Santa suits for men, ladies, and accessories too. Deck the halls with gingerbread men, candles, pillows, and snowmen too. Whether naughty or nice, we have the gift to fit your price. So come on down to Party Central. We are open from Monday to Friday, 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. and 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. on Saturdays. For more information, call 222-7781.
Calian Systems is a leading IT solutions company in Trinidad and Tobago. LG Electronics has recently partnered with us for the supply, installation, and maintenance of digital signage screens and TVs. We offer full range of maintenance services throughout the Caribbean. Our qualified technicians provide excellent on-call support on a 24-hour basis. Our bi-monthly service and maintenance contracts ensure reduced risk of failure or unexpected disruption of the digital signage service. We are the only company in Trinidad and Tobago to offer a 3-year manufacturer warranty on LG screens. To know more, contact us today.
Legacy and stability. I'm sure you would agree that these words ring true for those who want to invest in a secure future for their children, or even in retirement and desire to yield high returns. At TBLA, we can provide you with prudent investment instruments. So if you're looking for that future you longed for, then visit us at TBLA and find out which investment product is right for you. TBLA, a secure home to invest.
Car Excellence is the number one housewife's choice in Trinidad and Tobago and is now introducing a new range of products. White rice, parboiled rice, white sugar, brown sugar, and much more. Available at leading supermarkets nationwide.
It's a mega one-day sale this Sunday at Buyer's Mart. Plastic chairs, $75. 18-inch Lasco fan, $275. Half HP water pump, $350. Foot spa, $199. Beach chair, $99. 4-foot pre-lit Christmas tree, $150. Oven with rotisserie, $695. 8-piece car cover seat, $199. 4-slice toaster, $99. 4x6 mattress, $325. Thousands of items on sale. Don't miss this one. One day only.
And now it's real. Watch TNA Impact Wrestling every Thursday only on CNC3.
Welcome back to Dad and Tobago. I'm Hema Ramkseen, and this is The Morning Brew. Joining us on set now, Danielle Burnett and also Neil Burnett, and we're talking about obesity and health awareness, and they're having, to tell us more about the event. Good morning. How are you?
Good morning.
Fine, thank you.
Now, Danielle, we're talking about a bike ride that you're having?
Yes.
How did this event come about?
It first came about when I actually got myself active with triathlon and would go out on a Sunday long ride, every Sunday supposed to be. And I would see all these people riding of all different ages, different, you know, genders, all that. And so I thought, well, maybe if I use my initiative and I use the riding, I would get a good response, because there were a lot of people in that moment there already. So I knew if I just got the message out to them and they spread the message around their cyclists as well, I would get that good response.
In case you're wondering, Danielle is only 12 years old. Just by the way, a lot of times we hear about battling obesity and child obesity in our country. And your parents got you involved in sport very young.
Yes, they did.
And did you always like it? Do you now see sport as part of your everyday activity? And I have to ask it to you, because, you know, when you look at young children, most people think that it's a really hard task to drag them away from the television set.
Yes, it's a very, I love sports because I enjoy, it's a way for me to connect with my friends, for me to have fun, and I'm extremely competitive. Like, everyone in my school knows I'm competitive. Everything I do, I must be the best, so you always strive to be on top. And I mean, you won't do well every single time, but I accept that, so.
Well, Daddy, she always wants to be on the winning and getting that medal. Let's talk a little bit about how this, so did Danielle approach you and say, I want to do this?
Yes, she did. Danielle, at a very tender age, was involved in sport. We exposed her to a lot of things. I used to be in the military, mm-hmm. So she grew up in a military environment. So she's accustomed to running, sit-ups, stuff like that. Mm-hmm. And when she turned about 7, she started to get a little chubby. And we thought we would introduce her to triathlon, because she's a black belt in karate. She started karate at age 4. Mm-hmm. She is a very good swimmer. So we thought we would introduce her to biking and running and continue with the swimming. So she's now a triathlon athlete. And she wanted to share her experiences with other kids her age, because we have come to recognize that in Trinidad and Tobago, a lot of our parents compensate and overcompensate by taking our kids to KFC every Friday, fast food every day, and they tend to be a little chubby. So she started to get chubby. And with that now, she's picked up on it, and she herself came to us and said, Mommy, Daddy, I'd like to do this. I want to do this. And we said, fine, you have our support.
And do you get your friends involved in this?
Yes. A lot of them, the people that I train with, they are very involved with it. Like, I call them my MCs. When we go on the events, they help me out, like, sharing the message. And they enjoy it as well, because it's, you know, they understand and they see it. People in school as well. I have a little banner up in school, so everybody realizes. And so I'm expecting to get a good amount of support from my school.
Let's talk a little bit about it. And I know we have some graphics as well to share with our audience. So leading by example, asking a child to do something you are unwilling to do yourself will usually yield poor results for both parties. So practice what you preach. Strength training and cardiovascular training. Like all types of physical activity, strength training and aerobic training is calories, proper nutrition. It's typical that a parent will do the food shopping for the home, so it's imperative to make healthy, wholesome selections when food shopping. And encourage your kids to be kids and let them play. So today's youth is a way to set a tree with the technological era, making it much too easy to just sit around and be occupied.
Yeah, definitely.
And with more and more research pointing to activity increasing in child's potential for learning, it behooves us to support and encourage organized physical activity in and out of the schools. Now, you see the reaction and the need for parents to be involved. And I have to ask you, Neil, as a parent, you are disciplined yourself because you were part of the military, so fitness was part of your everyday routine. Getting your children to accept that as a lifestyle, how difficult was that in life? Because I'm sure when Danielle goes to school, all of her other friends may have the sugary items and may have the processed foods in their lunch bags.
Danielle, from a very tender age, is a very well-structured child. And she is particular about her diet, what she eats, and she pays particular attention to her coach. She is a member of Caribbean Cross Training, and her coach, who is Mr. Elegant, has, to some extent, a greater influence on Daniel than I do. Because if he says no starch for 2 weeks, and I try to take her to eat junk, she said, Daddy, no junk. So she's very disciplined when it comes to that. But it was very easy for her to be involved in sporting activity because she grew up in a military environment. She would see me doing sit-ups on mornings before I go to work. She would see me running. She'd see me doing that stuff. And it's very important for parents to participate with your children nowadays because we've lost that element of family unit. Mm-hmm. We need to bring that back and get the children and parents to work in tandem with each other. And I have tried my best to do that along with my wife and other siblings.
How many other siblings do you have?
Well, I have a half-sister, just my sister, and a brother who passed away a little while ago.
And your sister is just like you?
Not really. She didn't like sports. I tried to get her into it, but I tried to get her my two nephews. I tried to get them into sports as well, but they just don't really have, you know, the facilities and the times and so on. So when they come over here, I drill them.
Drill. Yeah, sounds like one of my trainers. But your closing comments, Anya, let's invite people to this event and understand why they should attend.
I invite all the public mainly. We don't want it to be like a gigantic ride, enough so we can control the group. But we start at St. Mary's Home in Tacarigua, and we would carry on to Arima, which at that point we would stop, talk, I would give a little speech. We would hand out flyers, fruits, and water. Then we would continue. We won't stay there too long so we don't cool down. I would then continue to Sandy Grande, where I do the same thing. Talk, hand out flyers, raise awareness. And then if you wish, you continue to Celebia, where you can relax for the rest of the day at a great price and use the facilities and, you know, enjoy yourself after a well-deserved break.
Your closing comments. You are the driving force behind this and the influential factor in Daniel's disposition. And I think a lot of parents go sitting down wondering, how do you do it? Because, you know, it's so easy to just prop your children in front of the television and not get involved in sport. And so your closing comments.
I want to encourage parents to be very selective in what they give their children to eat. You are what you eat. And we must pay attention to that. And I also want to thank all of our sponsors, all of the persons who have supported us, and I'd like to invite the public. I want to pay particular mention to the mayor of Arima, Mr. Hadid, and in particular, the chairman of the regional corporation in San Ugrande, Mr. Rondon, for all of the support that they gave us last year and they continue to give us this year. And I'd like to encourage the public to come out at the specific venues, Tacarigua Orphan Home at 6 o'clock on Sunday morning. We will reach to Arima by 7 at the dial, and then we will get to Sandy Grande by 8:15. So we want to invite the public to come out, bring your kids, it's a Sunday, come out and see what we can get you as being a part of the activity of sport, any sport.
The activity of any type of sports. And it's something that, you know, everyone should. If you are a runner or you actually have started riding, I think you'd understand the feeling that you get at the end and that exhaustion. It's so much pleasure, believe it or not. When you drop down at the top of Chancellor Hill, I think nothing is as exciting as that. That's telling how sad it is. We take a very short break. When we come back, we'll have more for you. This is The Morning Brew. Stay with us.
Varma Steel's annual Christmas sale is now on. Get reduced prices on Varma's high-grade roofing sheets, flashing, guttering, Z-purlings, decking sheets, steel beams, and PRC. Varma's high-grade roofing sheets with a life of 40 to 50 years will not get moss, fade, peel, nor rust like low-grade PVF and other low-grade sheets. Visit Varma Steel in Pleasance Park next to the St. Margaret's Police Station or call 659-4008. Varma Steel for the best in quality at the lowest prices.
Add magic to your home this Christmas. Atlantic Trading Company and Magic Mist brings a magical theme competition to you. All you have to do is purchase three or more powerhouse products, fill out your entry form, attach bill, and drop in the powerhouse box. The winner then receives a day with the Magic Mist team cleaning your entire home professionally. Enter the magical clean competition with powerhouse cleaning products today. Distributed by Atlantic Trading Company Limited. Competition approved by NLCB.
Green Dot Limited, wireless, digital, cable and internet masters. No phone lines necessary. Quick and easy installation. Unlimited internet access. Call 623-4643 and be part of the Green Dot today.
Cool Max Limited, number 43 John Street, Montrose, Chaguanas. We are the largest importer of air conditioned units in the country, sole distributor for comfy units in the Caribbean, and also the sole distributor for media units in Trinidad. We give you a 5-year warranty on media compressors. You also get a free voltage protector with installed units. With a wide stock of units, we are definitely your choice. Come into Cool Max Limited for the best quality and price.
Welcome to Touch and Taste, fine dining restaurant located at number 8 West Boundary Street, California Point Lisas, Trinidad. A place for the family, a place for friends, and a good line. Happy hour, Monday to Friday from 4 to 7 on the Terrace Lounge, Table 6 Sky Lounge, and the fine dining restaurant equipped with a state-of-the-art conference room. It's Touch and Taste. Follow us on Facebook or call 636-1912.
Holiday season, Digicel can make your Christmas even better with a chance to share in over $1 million in prizes. You can win one of five $100,000 home makeovers from Standard, plus lots of other great weekly prizes and freebies. Simply top up $30 or more, pay your Digicel bill on time, buy a handset, activate a 4G plan, or text the word WIN to 9811. Come together and make Christmas extraordinary. Digicel.
Mark. Yeah.
Ing.
Yeah.
Bird.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a postcard from Freda Felcher.
Lloyd, I'm your dad. No way.
I had a daughter.
I gave her up for adoption.
What if we go track her down?
You're hot for my daughter.
What?
Am I right?
What?
Am I right?
I've been dying.
I like her a lot.
Let's call her. It's ringing.
Whoever this is, we're in the middle of something very important here.
This is your dad.
What?
I gotta take this. It's my dad.
She's got me on hold.
Dumb and Dumber 2.
Check out the hotties at 12 o'clock. That's 3 hours away. Why can't I check them out now?
You come here, baby. My heart skip.
So cool, come on.
New episodes of The X Factor UK, Saturdays at 8 p.m., exclusively on CNC3.
We're watching every move our leaders make and reporting it all back to you with the most comprehensive local, regional, and international stories 7 days a week. CNC 3, 7 p.m. News. We're covering your world.
Welcome back, Trinidad and Tobago. Well, our final guest is stuck in some traffic, so what we're going to do is open our phone lines for a little bit. 627-865-8624-721. Looking at all that is happening in the country, from politics to crime, the situation in Brasso Seco continues as we look at what's taking place. You know, the investigation is still active. The primary suspect has been held, but the investigations still continue into what exactly has transpired in that story. 627-865-8624-721. We heard in the newscast yet another grandfather has been charged with sexual assault of three of his granddaughters. And so we implore all mothers and all members of any family to please know that sexual predators exist probably in any space. So sometimes even if you have familial ties with an individual, it doesn't necessarily mean that your children or your loved ones are safe. So it's 627-865-8624-721. Our phone lines are open. We just have a little bit of time to invite your calls, to get your thoughts on all that is happening in the country. We have a caller from Shagonas. Shagonas, good morning.
How are you, Ma? Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm okay. Hey, Ma, I was very sad to hear about our grandfather.
It is a sad and sickening story.
At 86 years old, you should be looking to make peace with your maker.
Yeah.
But instead, you molest your three grandchildren.
Yeah.
That is very sad. Anyway, have a good day, Hema.
Thank you so much. Enjoy your day. Let's take another quick call, 627-865-8624-8721. We continue to monitor that situation. So if you did hear the news at 7 o'clock this morning, an 86-year-old grandfather has been 84 has been charged with sexually assaulting his grandchildren. 627-865-8624-8721. Our phone lines are open. Also, we are looking at the situation with TNTech, and we did speak with the general manager of TNTech, and he said over the next 48 hours it's going to be a sort of a strenuous period as the repairs are expected to take place over the next 4 days. Let's take a call from Superior. Superior, good morning.
Hello, good day.
Hi, good day.
Hello.
Hi, good morning. You're on the air. Okay, I guess we've lost that call. As quick house rules, you listen on your telephone and not on your television. So you have to mute your television set, and because we're going to get the feedback. We have another call on the line. Hello, good morning.
Hello, good morning.
Good morning.
It is so ridiculous because I am a mother of 16.
Mm-hmm.
I have 28 grand and 4 great grand. And it is so... It's real ridiculous. It hurts me. I cry to know a man like that. He should be praying to God and asking God, you know, to keep him, to get his salvation.
Yeah.
It is so ridiculous.
Thank you so much. God. Thank you so much, ma'am. 627, we have another call on the line. Hello, good morning.
Hello, good morning.
Good morning. You're on the air.
Yes, I'm calling about the grandfather.
Yes.
Yes, I'm not saddened. I am very angry because I'm sure that this is not the first time that gentleman has interfered with children.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure there's a history, if you look into his background, with his children. And the grandmother has just decided to turn a blind eye to the whole thing. So I am very angry this morning.
I think we all have to be, ma'am. Thank you so much for sharing your thoughts this morning on that. And according to the reports that we received, the young girls did tell, I think they told a member of the family what was happening, and no one believed them. 627-865-8624-8721. We have another caller from Gasparilla. Gasparilla, good morning. Hello.
Hi, good morning, Hema.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm okay, and you?
I'm okay.
What I'm just putting to say, I love this program. I don't miss it at morning.
Oh, thank you very much.
I have a little baby girl and she's asleep, and I actually get up to cover watches. You know?
Oh, well, what's your daughter's name?
Akili.
Well, thank you to you and Akili for looking at our show every single morning. And thank you for inviting.
I'm calling concerning the issue with this grandfather.
Uh-huh.
And I find this is ridiculous. It's beyond acceptable.
Mm-hmm.
Because, I mean, someone coming to tell you, somebody in that frame with your child, you should take it at the first point. You shouldn't wait until they keep coming after and after and after again.
Yeah.
You know?
Okay, thanks so much, caller. We are out of time.
Seriously, a little more often.
Sure. Thank you so much. We take a bow. We're actually coming to the end of the show. On behalf of everyone attached to the show, I wish you a safe and blessed day. Have a wonderful day, Trinidad and Tobago. Bye.
The Morning Brew was brought to you in part by Wendy's.
Good morning, I am Akash Samaru with your news headlines on CNC3 and the TBC Radio Network. An 84-year-old Karapichima man will appear in court today after being charged for sexually assaulting his three granddaughters. The girls are said to be ages 8, 10 and 14. According to police, the girls had been complaining to their grandmother for some time, but she did not believe them. What makes this incident even more tragic is that inquiries reveal that the grandfather allegedly sexually assaulted the eldest of the girls when she was 10. He then allegedly started with the 10-year-old girl when she was 8, and according to the girls, recently began sexually assaulting the 8-year-old girl. Police say they found out when the 14-year-old girl informed her teacher. CNC3 understands all three girls were medically examined. After late last night, charges were being written against him, and counseling was being arranged for the children. TNTech says corporate entities will feel the pinch of a reduced power supply over the next few days, but it is necessary to keep the public satisfied. Yesterday, the electricity company announced that there will be load shedding as a leak developed at a pipeline that supplies natural gas to its generators. The company's general manager, Kelvin Ramsuk, said over the next 3 days, NGC will be attempting to fix the line, but until then, the public must conserve its electrical use. Mr. Ramsuk says right now the company's output is not the usual amount needed to satisfy the entire country. Hence, corporate Trinidad and Tobago has been told that it would have to scale back its use so the public is affected as little as possible.
1250 is the demand and 1050 is the available capacity. So we have a shortfall of about 200 megawatts. And that, by curtailing the industrial customers, as I said, PCS, Yara, CNC, Titan, Centron and so on, all the methanol plants at the Point Lisas Industrial Estate, we would be in a good position to be able to maintain supply to the rest of the country.
Petrotrin is accusing the Oilfield Workers Trade Union of being unreasonable during wage negotiations and not understanding the tough economic times that are facing the company. Petrotrin says due to its financial loss this year, which is in excess of $345 million, it must undergo cost management. It says it was also downgraded by the financial rating agencies to the lowest level of investment grade. Petrotrin says as such, its current proposal does not include any increase to the base salary of its workers. Petrotrin says due to the drop in oil price, this must be done if the company is to survive. It says it received a revised proposal from the OWTU, which it will review and respond to today. And in sport, Philip Hughes, the Australia Test batsman struck on the head by a ball 2 days ago, has died. The 25-year-old passed away after injuries sustained while batting for South Australia against New South Wales at the Sydney Cricket Ground. Hughes, who had played 26 tests, collapsed on the pitch after being hit by a ball from pace bowler Sean Abbott as he attempted a pull shot. Well, stay tuned. Another news update comes up at the top of the hour right here on CNC3 and the TBC Radio Network.
Christmas is here, bring the cheer to your day. Come, the boy, think of me, don't go. Hide, hide, praise in the sun, go in and dance, and in the dance. Hey, 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 my good. Vintage from CNC3.
The views and opinions expressed in the following program are not necessarily those of CNC3.
Touch Trinidad with the power of your spirit. Touch Tobago with the wonder of your name. Touch Trinidad with the love of the Father. Oh, precious God, touch Tobago.
Hello, my dear viewers. Let me tell you something. Your life can begin to change right now. Once you believe, your life can begin to change right now. You know, the biggest change in your life is not outside, but is inside. If you not take away what is inside of you, grudge, you know, hate, you hate your husband, your wife, you hate someone in your family, you don't like the way they behave, you don't like the way they talk, let me tell you something.